evil blanket fish has awoken.
All right. I'm coming in. Game sounds coming in. Everything looks good. So we're live, and we're probably going to be finishing up Star Ocean First Departure R today. Unfortunately, the arena didn't pan out, and I never got around to going to the old ruins. Partially because I didn't realize that at some point we wouldn't be able to go back to the rest of the world. And also I kind of decided not to give up Mavel, which would happen if I went there as far as I know. But we just got a dungeon or two, and I think there's also the big optional dungeon, the big hard optional dungeon. The Cave of Seven Stars we can do. I'll probably go through and finish the game and then reload save and start going through the Cave of Seven Stars and see if we can actually get through it all today. I don't know how long it is, but more than likely this will be the last day for this game. If for some reason can't make it through the Cave of Seven Stars, then you know, too bad, so sad, we'll just kind of stop there and move on. I'll probably leave this game installed and do another run at some other time, get different characters. Don't know if I'll stream it or not, we'll have to see. I try not to do too many replays so that I can move on to different games and showcase a lot of different ones. Anyway, when last we left, we were on the planet Farget. Which is apparently just a tiny rock from the size of the world map on it. I'm kind of curious if this bunny can make it all the way here. Apparently he can. But yeah, Millie got kidnapped, so we're going to go save her. And once we get her back, we then have to assault the leader of the third faction that got that disease that turned everybody to stone on Roke way back in the past. Who was apparently immune to lasers and explosives and all the other modern weapons they could possibly use on them, so they had to go old school and go grab all the magical and sword fighters from the past to be able to have a chance at killing him since he's a superhuman. Kind of a vague and very convenient plot device, but what the hell, it works.
Thanks in no small part to the distraction Evina's crew is providing for us. The soldiers are probably all gathered by the front entrance.
Let's move! We gotta find Millie and the others!
You got it. Don't let up!
This isn't good!
Divine Smite!
still raring to go!
You must be the guys who came to help us from Earth. I was worried they'd captured you. Run around checking everything out first.
Stay focused.
We're doing this?
Gale Hurricane!
Take this!
Phoenix Blast!
Omega Light Ray Blade!
Shadow Flare!
Divine Strike!
They put up a heck of a fight.
This isn't good!
This isn't an even match!
Sure looks strong.
I hope we can do this!
Play!
Take them. Yeah, there's our party members.
Roddick, over here.
Millie.
How's it look, Ilya? Can we get it open?
Oh my god, Millie, it was terrible! We had to add Ronix to the party!
This won't be a problem. Roddick, you came to help us, didn't you?
Everyone all right?
It felt so lonely without all of you.
I'm getting too old for this.
All right, now let's get out of here while the guards are still distracted.
Glad you're all safe.
We really appreciate your help. If it wasn't for your diversion, our rescue mission would have been a lot more complicated.
Oh, not at all. If anything, I should be the one thanking you. There's no way any of us could take down GA, no matter how hard we try. So really, you're our only hope.
Is it true that optical weaponry doesn't work on Revorse?
Yes. GA is the culmination of everything that Fargate's technology has to offer.
Well, why did they build someone so dangerous in the first place?
Fargate is a desolate planet. We have very little water and natural resources to work with. We've been conducting research into genetic engineering and spatial theory for a long time now. It's what we needed to do for survival, and to someday return home to Earth.
Home to Earth?
Yes. Long, long ago, our ancestors were sent from Earth to Fargate after a meteor strike opened up a spatial vortex in our homeland.
All right, they were talking about this earlier, about the people that disappeared when a meteorite hit.
Just like the old race was transported to Roke.
Unlike Roke, however, Fargate's environment is harsh and inhospitable to human settlement.
Yeah, it's just a big rock.
Frustrated in their efforts, our scientists finally decided to turn toward what was then considered forbidden research. They launched a project to create a race of superhumans, people uniquely adapted to life on our planet.
They conducted genetic engineering on humans?
Yes, and the result of that project is the superhumans, including GA. Their combined muscular, nervous, and brain systems make them uniquely adapted to coping with the severities of our environment. However, the core they were built from is still human, the genes that define all of us. Their life expectancy may outlast ours, but they are not immortal. You could say that's their sole weakness.
I suppose a direct strike is the only chance we have of killing Revorse.
Most of the army is off in outer space, participating in the Earth invasion. As leader, however, GA would never leave the planet voluntarily. With most of his guard away, sneaking into Revorse Tower, where he resides, is a distinct possibility.
But we can't just sit here, not when the army's already on the move.
Revorse Tower is located in Vad Goop, our capital. You'll find it north of here. There's a great big cliff in the way, though, so reaching it on foot is impossible.
So how will we get there?
North of Vad Goop, there's an old, closed-off laboratory. A biolab, to be exact. There should be an underground corridor below the lab that connects directly to Revorse Tower. It's pretty old construction, but hopefully it's still in service.
Well, it beats storming the place head-on, I guess. All right, let's head to the biolab.
Don't think I used any items, so I think we should still be full stocked. Actually, I did use one resurrection. See how much XP the monsters around here give.
They're behind us?
Behind us! Behind us! Behind us!
Wasn't a whole lot.
This looks bad.
We're doing this?
Divine strike!
Condition cure!
I want these things die. They don't seem to be taking any damage. Yeah, these things aren't taking any damage from me at all. Does this weapon have an element? Yeah, it does. It's water. Alright, so the end of this, I guess it's decent, but not really great XP from the enemies in the area, so probably better off just going to the dungeon. Still think it's hilarious the bunny can make it all the way over to this planet, asteroid, rock, whatever the hell it is.
This must be the biolab.
Yep, and it looks like it's been shut down for a while. Guess they were trying to develop plants capable of thriving on this planet.
Must have been pretty successful.
I guess. Let's go inside.
Let's look around more first.
It's that guy from before. The guy who took Millie hostage over in the demon world.
You're right. For gallantry displayed during Operation Asmodeus.
Captain, take a look at this.
The Revorce plan? This must have been where they did the genetic research that led to G.A. Revorce.
So they, 300 years ago, they got the genetic material from that guy who claimed to be a superhuman, Asmodeus. And they not only created that disease that turned everybody to stone, but they also used it on their current leader to make him a superhuman as well. From the looks of it.
That's not all.
That's Asmodeus.
It looks like Asmodeus was also a native of Farget. Another genetic engineering test case.
So how did he wind up in the demon world?
The record says that Asmodeus rebelled against his peers and escaped through a vortex, taking the space-time laboratory with him.
And that vortex was connected to the demon world.
Apparently, they were incapable of creating another Asmodeus-like superhuman afterwards.
So that's why they pursued him to get a genetic sample, because their research essentially ran away from them.
Interesting. Now I understand why they bothered going all the way to Roke to collect Asmodeus's DNA.
And G.A. Revors was created using Asmodeus's genes as a base.
Yep. This must be the corridor Evina mentioned.
Yep, we go all the way down this pipeline. Not a drop is right in front of Revors Tower.
Let's go. Refugees?
This is horrible. Why are they living in this place? The dictatorship is suppressing all the opposition, that's why. The larger the gap between the two sides, the more established the ruling party becomes.
But these people can't be happy living like this. Why don't they want to stand up and fight?
That's a problem for the locals. We can't force them to rise up. Who knows how they'll rebuild this place once Gia Revors is gone. I suppose the real battle for the Resistance begins at that point.
Well, I'm not gonna put up with this. Gia Revors is going down, I swear it.
I hope you never change, Roddick. As long as you don't, I know Roke will never end up like this.
Or, you know, when Roddick dies. Can't live forever, no matter how good your ideals are. I'm good about Vodgoop nowadays. No place to live anymore.
Soldiers? I guess not.
Whew, that's a relief.
I think this is the final dungeon of the game.
Here it is. Revors Tower.
It won't be long before we have to face GA.
Yeah. We're going to end this here. We can't let him keep people in misery any longer.
I'm gonna give it all I've got!
Okay, so that's a shortcut to come back. In grand JRPG tradition, the final... It looks like the final dungeon is a teleporter maze. Or maybe not. Maybe it's just a floors.
Divine strike!
Yeah, let's see how these work out. For the longest time, I didn't have access to this stuff because I forgot to buy Sense 1 in, like, the first town. That was literally the only town it was sold in.
Thunder Surge!
not moving! I hope you're watching, Father!
So we got Red Worm Thunder Surge, which is probably that one. Yeah, Phoenix Blast. I think that's literally the last one we need to get upgraded for him. Yeah, I still think that one will do more damage since it lowers their defense, but I guess I'll just stick with the Force Sword so I don't have to worry about if they resist or ignore or absorb water. So it looks like... My head's not fire. Hey, Cappy.
I'm still nowhere near the end of the road.
Alright, what kind of kitty do you want? We have the black kitty, the Scottish kitty, which is black but with the little, like, tucked down ears, an orange tabby, white and gray, or a pure white. Those are the options.
Alright, there we go. Scottish kitty.
Ship Discovery. It went missing in the 21st century.
Did it get sucked through a wormhole to Farget or what?
Hey, Clash. How you doing today?
It was lost a good 700 years ago. It must have gone back in time 500 years or so.
I'm doing pretty good.
Now, this would certainly explain how Farget managed to obtain their spacefaring technology.
Nah, we got sent to a tiny little planet. And that's the end. We have to assassinate the leader of a foreign force. Some kind of healing item. I don't know if it's for HP or MP, but the syrups are usually healing items. Sour syrup, 30% of a user's MP. We'll be right back.
take them?
Rainbow diamonds. Let's keep going right first before we start taking side paths. Meteor swarm. It says you learned it. I'm kind of curious who learns it. Is it all my spellcasters? Might just be Ronix. Yeah, it's just him learning those spells. Hermit's cap. I got a whole other hallway that I'm gonna skip by. They go up here.
Sure looks strong.
We can't lose this.
Divine strike! Dragon splash! Black worm thunder surge!
Stronger!
Oh, I guess not. I think for some reason I didn't notice that wall there, and I thought I'd skip the path. Effort, determination, resilience. Yeah, so they all should have it on. So we're essentially training with weights right now because we're slowed down to get more SP when we level. And the rest of our stats are down so that we can level up faster. Yeah, what I thought was a branching path was actually fairly linear. Just make sure I haven't missed anything. This was a... yeah, I already had... that's why. I can't hold anymore. Went here, yeah, there's nothing.
Yeah,
Yeah, I think I've got everything on this floor.
Sure looks strong.
Be careful, everyone! Fairy healing! I feel a little jump!
Just a full
fairy healing!
Thank you very much!
Hey, finally learned Omega Strike. Been waiting for that forever. I wonder how many floors there are. Oh, already maxed out on those. Nothing.
This looks bad.
We'll just have to break them down!
Omega Strike!
Never mind, she got it. Just about to resurrect him. That's weird, I couldn't explore this whole floor.
This looks bad.
We'll just have to break them down!
Jump! Cancel!
Hurricane! this!
Whistling and animal training. I need that on Perici. Since I think she actually has a talent for it. Actually, I said more skill suspend.
Thank you.
Alright. Let's see what will probably be a boss. Maybe not. Maybe that's just like a midway point save.
This isn't good!
Ooh, now what?
I honestly don't know if I've already done that, because I haven't been really paying attention to what floor I'm on. I've just been going... So far, it's been pretty linear. Like, it's just going down the corridors until you hit the next teleporter. I think I want to keep that on her. Hey, Calabash, how you doing today? I'm doing pretty good.
We overwhelmed them.
More than likely, I feel like I'm going to finish this today. I'll finish the story, and then, which way did I go in? Is this the way I came?
Didn't look like it. Yeah, that's what I was saying. I was going to finish the story and then reload, save, and do the extra dungeon afterwards.
Keep focused, and hey, hold on a second.
See how far we can get. What the hell was that? Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. I was like, basically just gonna go till end of stream. If I finish the extra dungeon, cool. If not, we'll just see how far we can get into it. What is with the insta-kills? Yeah, because I think from second story on is when they started doing the, like, Gabriel, Celesta, and all them in the dungeon. Which then just became a Tri-Ace thing, and they were in every game that Tri-Ace made.
I'm guessing that was for Cius if he was here. Yep. So that's for anyone.
Go, bird, fly! The way I came? That's the way I came. Or is it? I think I may be going backwards.
Hey! Hold on a second!
Now what?
Thunder Surge!
Light!
you very much.
No. Ha!
Well, there you go.
Power up!
Yep, I was going the wrong way. Alright, we got a music change. And a change in scenery.
Sure looks strong.
I hope we can do this!
Gale, hurry!
Skeeto in here.
Oh!
like just zero frame startup murder attack. What the fuck is that attack? Yeah, no, that attack is just ridiculous. Like, in the span of time it took him to do the, like, slight step back that he does to do Omega Death Slash, it just murdered him from, like, almost full. Where does this go to? Oh, this is to the extra dungeon? Stupid mosquitoes.
Sure looks strong.
This looks tough. Ha!
Omega Strike! Ha!
Ha! Omega Double Slash! Omega Thunderclap Blade! Thanks! Ha! Ha! Dragon Slash!
Ha!
Yeah, so this is where I'll be coming back to after I've finished the game.
This isn't good!
I hope we can do this!
Thank you very much.
Why would you run to that side? I was already right next to him. I swear the worst enemy in this game is the targeting.
Thank you.
Hold on a second!
I hope we can do this!
Gale Hurricane!
He's got a scouter. He's checking our power levels.
Dogs to make it this far.
GA Revorce, you're going to stop hurting people starting right now.
I am merely trying to fulfill the ardent wish of every man, woman, and child on Farget. The Mu'a who were snatched away from Earth have spent millennia hoping, praying for a way to get back home.
So, that warrants an invasion? If a home is all you want, there has to be a better way.
The people of Earth have incessantly squandered the resources Mother Nature gave to them. Don't you think it's time they received a taste of their own medicine? Just like the Mu'a did when they were thrown off their homeland.
I don't think so. When did Dragon Ball Z... Not even when Dragon Ball Z started airing. You'd have to probably look up when the manga portion of that first came out. Even then, the first episode, which a couple episodes in is when they introduced the Scouters, was in 1989. So it's definitely... DBZ Scouters are definitely way before this.
I don't think that's for you to decide.
So you want it all to be in some god's hands? If so, I will become that god. I've already laid hands on the creator role here. If being the creator of all things makes you a god, then all that remains is for me to take the throne for myself.
We're not gonna stand here and allow that!
I fight in order to protect my own life. If you won't even let me do that, then why was I created? I see no point in further discussion. Only the strong survive. The first law of nature, wouldn't you agree? Now, allow me to show you just how insignificant you are.
Yeah, which is 7 years after Dragon Ball Z aired in anime form. It was 1989.
Keep focused, everyone!
Allow me to grant requiem.
And that's in anime form. The manga would have been way before that.
I needed that! Omega Thunderclap Blade!
Like, he even looks like Vegeta right there.
All shall fall into the abyss, even the light of hope.
Very light.
Oh, now you learn it when I probably don't even have time to switch it out. Oh, enemy time. Probably not, but I just wanted to have them all and at least try them out. I guess I can try it out when I'm in the extra dungeon. Oh wait, no, never mind, because I'd be starting before this, so he might not learn it.
Divine purging. This battle has been decided. There is no turning back the clock. You will sleep now. Sleep eternally.
I needed that. I needed that. Jump! 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 Jump!
This battle has been decided. There is no turning back the clock. You will sleep now. Sleep eternally.
I can only assume that that move is just giving whoever it hits it with an epileptic seizure with all the flashing lights.
There is no turning back the clock. You will sleep now. Sleep eternally.
I can't die yet.
I feel alive.
Now you've done it.
Move a little faster.
Good timing.
This battle has been decided. There is no turning back the clock. You will sleep now. Sleep eternally.
Now you've done it.
Move a little faster!
We got a third form.
Well, there you go.
I'm just too strong, aren't I?
Guess not.
Did we do it?
Wasn't really hard, just slightly annoying.
Is he gone?
All he wanted was to survive in the end, didn't he? All the power in the world can't help a person overcome a fragile spirit, I suppose.
Maybe that's the secret. Maybe you need a weak body to be strong in spirit.
Perhaps. When I look at the Rokians, I can't help but hold out some hope for the human race, too.
They may not have the technology, but they have the heart. We could learn a lot from them.
Thanks for everything, you guys.
Why the sad face? Who's to say this is goodbye forever?
Take care, everyone. I promise I'll never forget any of you.
This turned out to be some training. I'm never gonna forget this.
We're friends forever, okay? Goodbye, everyone!
Thank you.
They're all gone.
Elia.
Things might have been different if I were born on the same planet as you. Listen, you take care of Millie, all right? Girls like that don't come along every day.
You ready, Elia?
Yes, just had some personal things I had to say to Roddick, that's all.
Well, let's get back to Roke then.
I'm gonna be the best swordsman in the world.
Ha! You kidding me? You couldn't do that in a million years.
I'll get you for that, you bastard.
If you're gonna dream, you've gotta dream big. That's what I say.
Can't disagree with that. What more evidence do you need that we're finally at peace?
Roddick, the path of a swordsman is infinitely treacherous. But I know you have what it takes.
I already learned all your skills, old man. Learned the last one in the final boss fight.
We defeated the Crimson Shield and the Archfiend who used him. I've gotten revenge for my parents. I've reached my life's goal, but the emptiness hasn't gone away. I was driven by revenge. I even sacrificed my body for it. But all I wound up doing was averting my eyes from my own crimes. How am I supposed to deal with the sheer weight of them all by myself? What am I supposed to do? Yoshua.
Can't believe how strong they all were. I'm gonna be just as strong someday. I don't care how much training it takes.
Here goes.
I mean, she could have stayed in cat form and we could have kept her with us.
I suppose this is gonna be goodbye for good then.
Yeah, but I may come back here and pay you a visit.
Let's just hope it's a friendly visit the next time.
But I do hope you two will come and visit us again soon. Just give us a little warning next time.
We will. I still think Roke would be better off as an undeveloped civilization. I think that's best for your planet.
Agreed. Getting developed means having air pollution, contaminated water, chemicals in your food, and losing your forests to industry. There's nothing positive about it.
Oh, I think there is.
Huh?
Well, for one, we wouldn't have had the chance to meet you guys. And we wouldn't have gone on this amazing adventure. Don't worry about us. We are going to make Roke even better than before.
Yeah, well, we can't wait to come and see what you've accomplished.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, goodbye!
I'm glad I had the opportunity to work with all of you.
Yes, we're glad too, but the real adventure for us is only just beginning.
I don't know. even if I don't stream it, I'll record it. So if nothing else, it'll end up on my YouTube. So one way or another, it'll be up for viewing. But yeah, if I do it in my own time, I'll make sure to record it and put it on the YouTube. Because I don't know how long it is. It may not be enough to fill out a whole stream. Now I finished the game. Now I'm going to, once the credits and everything, the whole ending's done, I'm gonna reload from the last save and do the extra dungeon. I don't know how long that'll take, though, so it may still be a short stream. Had I not spent so much time bashing my head against the wall in the arena yesterday, I probably could have finished this yesterday. Because it took about 2 hours, and that's about how long I was in the arena, just failing over and over again.
I think there's supposed to be more to the ending after the credits. Like, I think there's stuff after the credits based on the affection ranks between teammates. That should be the end of the English credits. I guess not. So either I was mistaken that there's more after the credits, or my affection levels were crap. Gave a 7 stars, a waste to test your bravery, though CK challenged me to access this dungeon from the basement of Revor's Tower. Missing 3 movies. Shouldn't at least one of these be the ending? Did we not unlock that? Oh wait, wrong one. The one further south.
Thunderclap Wade! fast, everyone!
Be careful, everyone!
Gale Hurricane!
Omega Double Slash!
Wait, this is where we came in. Eh? What are your options, Lord Jiggs? Granted, there's not really anything high-end, but there are a lot of options, just not really anything high-end at 7-Eleven. Each level, you'll be able to listen to the stories of the Tria, gods of creation, exactly as recorded for the SFC version. That means some of them might not make sense. If that happens, just humor them and move on. Alright, so they didn't go out of their way to translate these two well, is what I'm hearing. Welcome, my friends. I hope you enjoy this dungeon. I won't say any more, except the movable statues may be important. Any of these movable? No. Okay. Kinda just got murdered. Sure, go for it.
Hmm.
see the way forward.
We've been ambushed!
No!
Omega Strike!
Canceled somersault! Ha!
Jesus. Okay, so the enemies in this dungeon are definitely out for blood. Yeah, I can understand that. Because I'm sure you're probably worried that if you do get taken off the meds that it may get worse. But you probably also want to be off of them because, as you said, they kind of make you not want to do anything. It's definitely a situation where there's cons either way. I mean, hopefully if you can get taken off, and maybe if you're able to find some other way to... Yeah, maybe if you can find some other way to deal with the mood swings. I don't know too much about bipolar disorder, so I don't know what techniques there are to try to reduce the mood swings naturally. I would guess off the top of my head, maybe meditation or breathing techniques or something, or just pure stress management. But I don't know that very well.
Keep focused, everyone.
Be careful, everyone.
But as I said, hopefully you can get off them and be able to have some measure of control over your mood swings to where you can actually function in life. I mean, it could be, but in and of itself, I don't think marijuana and alcohol use cause that, but if you're already prone to it, it could probably exacerbate it. So unfortunately, it might have been something that was already brewing in your brain chemistry, and all of that just amplified it. Unfortunately, that is a problem for some people, that they just, you're essentially kind of a ticking time bomb that you don't know, and then you just do things that are perfectly normal for other people and don't really harm them, but for you, it does damage. Everybody's different. Something that could be harmless to one person could be harmful to another, and unfortunately, a lot of times you don't even know until it's too late. But I hope the best for you. Like I said, I hope they can get taken off the medicine and you can control it at least to a degree that you can feel comfortable.
This isn't good!
Be careful, everyone!
Ha! Omega Strike! Ha!
This is nothing!
Omega Strike!
Very healing!
Thanks!
Omega Strike!
Dragon Strike!
Omega
Strike! Surge!
Omega Strike!
Okay. That's good. I will say though, one of the hardest parts of doing that, just as I've noticed, because I don't drink or do drugs or anything either, is just a lot of people have a hard time understanding that when you meet them. It usually becomes a whole conversation as to why you don't do anything. Normal fights in this place feel like boss battles. No, I just never really got into them. It was sort of one of those things where it wasn't anything hard to give up because I never really started.
Cure! Jump! Cancel! Somersault! Jump! Cancel! to get back home.
Well, shit. Well, I'm gonna go on my midstream break, so I'll be back in 4 or 5 minutes. And while I'm on that break, I'm going to decide if I want to actually try to keep doing this, or maybe just start up on something else. Because I do have my kind of designated filler game to fill time if I finish something early in a stream, which is Half Minute Hero. I may just start up that, because I'm already seeing that in order to do this dungeon, I'm probably going to have to sit there and grind a lot before I start venturing through it. Because right now, every random encounter is like a murder fest. Huh. Alright. So, like I said, let me go ahead and I'm going to take my midstream break, and probably when I come back, I think we're probably going to do Half Minute Hero. So, I'll be back in a few minutes.